Really, when my grandson was diagnosed, he was 7. He was in second grade, not quite 7, in second grade, and was diagnosed with Asperger's syndrome, which we had never heard of. So, in the interest of finding out everything we could possibly get our hands on about Asperger's, it quickly turned into a concern, a personal concern of much more than Asperger's, of the whole autism spectrum and children and adults who deal on the autism spectrum, and how we need to be. I've obviously, a lot of it is about education. It's the reason I wear my Autism Speaks pin every day. People always ask me about it, and it gives me a chance to talk about how we need to be aware, and we need to provide the funding, but we need to provide the services, and I think most of all, we need to have family support and love. You know, one of the things when I decide to leave the assembly that I will always be the most proud of. Well, I guess two things, but the one that has had the most widespread effect on thousands and thousands of people is the autism insurance bill. Autism was never covered by insurance. It wasn't seen as a health issue. It is a health issue. And for the relief for children and the families of children and adults to know that that then the insurance companies had to pay for speech and occupational and physical therapy and some of these services that are just desperately needed by the children when they're young. And it guarantees that an adult with autism can be covered by health insurance. So that's something that, you know, took us 2 or 3 years to get it passed and signed into law, but I'm incredibly proud of my role in that and working with the sponsor, Joe Morelli, on that legislation. And the other is that every year I do an Asperger's Syndrome Recognition Day. The governor declares May 12th each year as Asperger's Syndrome Day. It is my grandson's birthday. If that's my resolution, I can pick the day. And Jeremy this year will be 21 on May 12th. So it's the ninth year I've done the resolution. And again, it's about education. I do it on Jeremy's birthday, but the main focus of the resolution. And almost every member of the assembly signs on to the resolution, and is education, is saying, you know, we have to accept that not everybody's the same, and help those and support those whose minds work differently than ours. You know, one of the reasons I voted against the teacher evaluation proposal for many reasons. I think a lot of it is flawed, but certainly the biggest concern that I hear from so many teachers is that there is no exception for special needs children. You know, part of the comment being made by State Ed is that they've applied for a waiver from the federal government, but that's not a good enough answer. We cannot be demanding that our special needs children take the test. It's bullying. At least it's bullying. There's people who call it child abuse. To have a child who either is nonverbal or can't read, sitting for 90 minutes to take a test that they can't understand and most likely will not pass is awful for the child. But then to take a very, very good and compassionate and loving teacher and say, because your students aren't passing that test, you're an ineffective teacher and could lose your job in 3 years. Absolutely outrageous. And we've got to change that system, and it should be changed certainly immediately. This idea of waiting and putting everybody through that kind of stress, it is just so, it's totally unacceptable. We were hoping to get the changes, and right now it's been, you know, we didn't put in a lot of the guidelines in the legislation, so it's up to the State Education Department and the Board of Regents. You know, I wish I had a lot of confidence in them to do the right thing. Hopefully they will look at some of this and just say, you know what, we're not going to put our kids, our special needs kids through this. And there are always children who can't test well anyway. So the teacher evaluation should not be linked to the test scores, I don't believe, for any children. But it is particularly inappropriate for those who don't have the intelligence level, and I don't mean that in a bad way. It's just the reality of it, who just can't possibly comprehend and do the work that many other students can do. There's a lot of resources. When I look back at even what, I've watched develop over the last 13, 14 years that I have been really in tune with it, there's certainly many more resources. SUNY Plattsburgh has done a tremendous job of having, under the auspices of Dr. Pat Egan and Dr. Lacey Charette, some great autism or and particularly Asperger's programs. They go year round. To help students, they're very valuable. The Traumatic Brain Injuries Center has done a a lot of education and worked a lot with children and adults. So there, and in our public school systems, I think given the financial stress that our schools have been under, they have done everything they possibly can, particularly here in the North Country, because again, we care about every single student. But the cost is horrendous, and it can be overwhelming, and it can take a huge amount of money for students who, are have multiple disabilities as well as autism. I mean, there can be many other physical disabilities at the same time for children, and so I think that for years, many of these children went to BOCES and. As funding shifts changed, a lot of them have come back to the school districts, and I'm not sure we're serving anybody well under some of those circumstances. So I think it's been something that's been easy to for state education and for the Board of Regents and people who sit in offices and don't go into the school systems and really talk to the teachers and talk to those who are teaching these wonderful, wonderful young students, and working through the problems these students have, that it's easy for them to set up standards and institute rules that when you're in there in a classroom, are just simply not reality. And that's part of what I see my role is. Again, it's not just education, helping the students and their families. It's hopefully going the other way and saying to those who are making the regulations, get out of your office and go and spend an entire day or a few days sitting in a classroom with a group of special needs young students and see what they're going through. And they're wonderful. They're loving. They're just a great group of students and. I work with a lot of them. I work with a lot of their families, and it will always be one of the highlights of this job is the opportunity to do so.